time on the MISADVENTUROUS, puny adventurous, come a woman to Mungo Bungo's temple and cheat to steal the making stone of the earth. But puny rat thing named Herman cannot return them to their home time, so they are trapped a wepta in the pasta westa. And welcome back, everybody, to MISADVENTUROUS.
Marcus would be so sad. He missed
it. Really insane. Josh couldn't join us, but he's here with us again. Welcome back, Mr. Jang. I hope you're doing all right.
I'm doing fine, thank you.
Oh, he gets along, he gets around. Ethan is, of course, here, being fabulous as usual.
Yeah, that's 100% true.
I am bringing fabulous. The utmost enthusiasm and professionalism to his performance. And, of course, we have with us...
You know, I was considering if the microphone might have cut out for you again. But I realize now that was just the suspense.
It was just sort of the warning before you, so you could take off your fucking headphones. Hi, Mitchell.
Hi.
Mitchell's dead.
My ears bleed now, so that's terrible.
Nope.
Can we just not ever do that? Can we just not? I understand you have, like, a perfect understanding of the elephant seal language, but my ears.
It's a stick. I like that stick for one.
I only learned it enough so that I could say I love you. And you the same, of course. So far, I've gotten down most of the alphabet. But this is an ASMR show, everybody. Didn't you know it?
Oh my god, we are the worst D&Ds. 5 minutes in and off track.
Most of this is going to get cut out.
I'm watching YouTube right now.
Okay, if you were paying attention, Winchin, then you would know that all of you guys, except of course Mark, who unfortunately can't join us today, so his character has been hit in the head with a coconut and has dropped on the ground, are outside the crumbled ruins of the Temple of Mungo Bungo. You are currently in a prehistoric jungle, roughly 75 million years in the past. Herman has just failed to activate the summoning circle that would take you all back home, because his master has not been born yet.
Wonderful.
Josh, as you wake up, you notice that Ethan isn't there. You don't see his character.
Alright. Okay, well... Hey, Eli. Alright, well, he's gone.
Eli's now on the ground unconscious. There's a Kuotoa currently trying to go through his pockets.
I'm going to shoo away the Iokoa. And I pick up Mark and throw him over my shoulder.
You now have obtained one average-sized white man.
I'm so sorry, Eli. I might use your body as a weapon if I can.
Might? Do you know what show this is?
I mean, I'm just saying. I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt to do whatever, but...
Herman is currently having a mini seizure on the ground.
Did I just hear Josh say he wants to use what's his name's body as a weapon? Mark's?
It's Eli's body.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Who is this Mark you speak of?
Yep, you did hear that correctly.
Right. We gotta do this in-character thing. Hold up, let me just put back on my elf ears before I...
Come on, Atlantis. Volantis.
You have equipped one set of elf ears. They add +2 to shittiness.
I mean, like, I have at least +9.
They add +2
like
to being a conceited dickhead.
I mean,
what about your conceited dickheadedness? Where's that at right now?
So Josh doesn't.
I mean, it's sitting at
there,
a solid
right?
15.
Oh yeah, you are there, my friend Ethan. But your character's body is currently, you know, about the third of the size and. Still blue, but naked.
And no horns and no
hair. Right, he's a halfling.
Oh, by the way, Josh, there's a naked blue halfling here. Just figured I should tell you.
Nice. So you look pretty blue. Are you McTavish?
So we just assume all blue people is
Let me just
McTavish.
Let me just prepare myself. I need some water real quick.
I'm talking to this little fucking.
Welcome back to the world of the living! How nice of you to join us again! We could have used you for those trials!
I don't like this.
Now I remember exactly why I don't hang out with
him. I'm a smaller target now.
My best friend Eli is unconscious, and now we have this to deal with. I wasn't prepared for any of this.
What are you talking about? You've known me for, like, a few weeks.
Look, you like, need to get the best or I kick you. This is too much to take in. Look, I see dinosaurs and I pass out and I come back to this. I'm not...
I mean, I have always been a halfling.
Deception.
Atlantis, please tell me you're okay.
I mean, just... I stopped trying to think about it a long time ago, okay? Like, I'm hanging out with a giant dragon guy, a blue halfling, and this human just passed out next to us, man. I don't...
Guys, do you guys happen to have any, like, clothes or something I can wear?
Do I have any clothes on me?
I have, like...
Oh, on you, Josh? I don't know. You definitely have a shirt that you don't normally wear.
Alright, here you go.
Oh, I take it, and I assume it is a nice full-length robe for me.
You receive one human-sized, well, not human-sized, it's dragonborn-sized shirt from Josh, which on you creates a circus tent of clothing upon you.
Nice. A lovely full-length cloak for me.
You could sort of use it as a cloak, but it definitely trails the ground like a bridal dress.
Well, I'll just pull out my... Wait, I don't have...
Do you have a dagger I could borrow?
Well, and I just thought my voice was annoying, says the shrunken head of your master on the side of your hip.
I'm gonna be like, Master, you know this sort of thing happens, right? It's magic.
Oh, I'm aware that things like this happen, but I wasn't aware they immediately turn you into a faggot what wears dresses.
You don't even have eyes!
Yeah, and even without them, I can see how gay you look!
I will feed you to a dinosaur.
Yeah, I'll come out of there and I'll kick the shit out of you. Come on.
You'll be the shit. You're gonna be the shit out of them.
All right, so.
Oh, and by the way, guys, you can do something
much,
in the bushes.
What?
How much do I have to pay to make that happen? Like, I would love to see a giant floating head come out and beat up a blue halfling. Let's do this.
I will not do it for any less than one plum oil rubbed down and three other shrunken head bitches.
Oh, Master, sorry about your,
You know what? If the moment I find
hole.
Three other shrunken head bitches.
Well, I mean, the one that was in the... that I had before is now turned to ash.
Oh, definitely been incinerated. Oh, yes, 100%. By laser wazers.
Mm-hmm. Laser wazers.
Okay. Also, Herman is foaming at the mouth down there.
Yeah,
I'm
going
to check on Herman.
To say, I want to go check on him.
I want to go look at the noise you heard from the bushes.
Well, Mitchell, with your amazing ability to see sound, you observe the noise. I'm sorry.
You look straight at that noise.
Tell me about the sweet-ass sound waves. Like, what color are they? What do I
they,
see with these sound waves? Let's keep going.
They're pretty high in the tenor department, but the basses is really, really long and stretched out. You could definitely tell that
could
if someone cut this up, they could make an amazing glitch hop piece.
Cool. Could I see where the sound waves are coming from?
Oh, yes. With your amazing eye ears, you can tell that those sound waves are emanating from some bushes just nearby at the edge of the clearing, right where the jungle reaches its thickest point.
Let's go look at those. Let's go look at that bush.
Clank, 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 clank. As you approach the bush, you see Akuatoa pop out of it, wearing a loincloth. It has a bone through his nose. It looks at you apprehensively, considering its very diminutive stature.
What's up, little guy?
Other men's.
He motions to the rest of your group. Trapped here?
Right, so... yes.
Flat a little bit.
Out. Currently.
No! He smacks his hands on the ground.
Sin on him!
No! No thing! He smacks his skull. No thing! No! No way out!
So you're saying there's no way out, period? I mean,
no! He smashed his hands in the grass. It's synonym. Word that means same thing. Different thing. Perhaps same sound. Okay. He picks up a branch and writes the word K-N-O-W. No. Me. No. Way out.
Uh-huh. Dude, he just called you a cow.
Oh, you know the way out.
Kick his ass.
Oh, okay.
Kick his ass.
All right, so
world star. Little Kuotoa guy scrambles into the bushes and then pulls apart some of the branches and points down to a clearing. That way, you go, find a way out. Give.
Man,
he holds out his hand,
like
expecting. Holds out his hands, expecting payment for his tip off.
I'll give him a silver.
Well, me and Dirge here aren't nearby. We're checking on Herman.
Oh, you're definitely over in the clearing, but you can see this going on.
Don't give him shit, Valantis.
Thank you very much,
Andrew.
And you're going to stop me, Hal? Yeah.
I mean,
he takes that.
Is that what I give him a silver? He said he wanted payment.
Sniffs it. Bites it. Looks both angry and confused in a very, very typical fashion of someone that's completely uneducated.
End it wisely, little buddy.
Mm-hmm. Wait, what do you mean uneducated?
Shop.
He knows what synonym means.
78 million years from now.
Okay, fine. He's...
Okay.
You can be immediately educated and still be ignorant as fuck. I mean, look at me. I've got part of a college education and my ass is still pretty wretched.
I don't know, this guy seemed like he got a pretty solid head on his shoulders.
He's walking away with his silver saying, go make investment real estate.
Man, he puts that in the bank in 78 million years when that money's useful. He's gonna have a lot of money.
Or he's gonna have one piece of silver in a hole in the ground.
Okay,
Herman has somewhat pulled himself out of his stupor saying, Did that savage just say that he knows a way out of here?
I mean, I wasn't really
I think so.
Yeah, apparently there's something down that way.
Then, I suppose... Nothing venture, nothing gain, gentlemen. Excuse
me. It's okay. Come here.
I'll
put him on my shoulder.
I want to grab that coconut that hit Eli in the head, crack it open, and give some to Herman.
The coconut is mighty. The coconut is strong. You must roll athletics to break the coconut.
Oh. I am totally going to do this with my -1 athletics. That was a 19 on the dice. 18 overall.
Ah, way to go. With your incredible kung fu grip, you need a rock in order to break the coconut. But you break it, boom, the coconut is now open.
All right, I'm going to let Herman have some.
Herman looks at that and says, You do know I don't eat, right?
What? Oh.
Only for pleasure. I don't need sustenance.
Oh.
Mitchell, after paying the strange little fisherman, you can now see a path that goes straight into the jungle.
Hmm.
Ethan, Josh, dealing with Herman has left you with a little bit of insight. The guy is a nervous wreck.
I mean, is it?
Also, Josh, when you let Herman up on your shoulder, he remarks on how nice you smell.
Oh, okay. Thank
you. I will hand half of the coconut to Dirge.
Oh.
I eat it in one fell swoop.
You have now fulfilled your daily requirements for cocoa, nut, fiber, and hipster water, all in one setting.
Okay. Thank you, McTavish. I don't actually like coconut, but I appreciate it as a chewing thing.
As long as it's not me being eaten.
Why? I'm not going to eat you. Why are you concerned about this?
I saw what you did to those goblins.
And what did he do to provoke it?
To be fair, though, look, if I was 3 feet tall, I'd be really afraid of you eating me.
I mean, you saw what those goblins were wearing. They were asking for it.
Do you see what I'm wearing?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
No, I don't, because I ain't got eyes, remember?
Ethan, you're looking...
Dumbass,
you ever seen those cartoons where, like, they're looking at something and it turns into, like, a walking cooked chicken? I mean, that's not actually happening because I'm not a fucking savage.
I mean, that could be happening because of wild magic.
You're being dragon racist, and I don't appreciate it.
All it takes is one avalanche, fam. That's all I'm saying. Shall we, gentlemen?
Might as well.
Let's go.
Venture into the deep jungle. A lot of modern day animals in this prehistoric jungle, but what the fuck ever, you get the sound.
I'm gonna look around nervously because I'm small.
So, roll perception.
Okay.
Ooh, that's such a good roll. That is.
Seven.
All right, what's everybody else gonna do before I tell Ethan what he got?
I would like to talk to Herman.
Herman says yes.
So, if we can't get back with you, what are our other options?
Well, we could die here in the jungle in our best attempts to survive in a prehistoric environment with foreign bacteria, life forms, and terrain.
Okay, well, let's say we want to skip that.
Okay, let's see. I could attempt to, No, that'd be a terrible idea. Those people are crazy.
We should explore this option.
I want to look over at Herman. Be like,
were you holding the chalk? The chalk we had?
Yes, I am.
I mean, I helped you with that other one.
Another question kind of? For you, Herman. Because your master is dead, does that mean... Or, well, not existing. Does that mean you can't... You don't have all of his knowledge? Are you actually, like, just thinking on your own here?
Well, in a sense, I was thinking on my own to begin with. I've existed for the entirety of my master's magical career.
Right.
I was his first creation, you see. And though I began as a mere extension of him, over the eons, eventually he made something else for me besides a body. I've always had free will, ever
so
since.
So you just can't mechanically use his
powers. I have an idea!
Okay.
I cannot.
I have an idea. Hear me out.
Said Herman.
Your master has ancestors, right?
Yes.
Do you think they might be inherently magical?
That is an interesting question. But I think the biggest difficulty there is the material plane may not have had humans on it at this point in existence. So far, all we've seen is Kotoa, and of course, he looks off in the horizon. You can see a brontosaurus going, I'm a fucking dinosaur, bitch!
Is that exactly how he goes?
Yes, exactly. He seems to be wearing an ugly crew neck.
Is he close enough to fist bump?
No, he's like a mile and a half away. He's definitely a piece of the cedar.
Alright, well, what's this about these people who are too dangerous? Let's go back to this.
Well, is it? And that is when something leaps out of the bushes at Ethan!
Okay, so very important note. Very important note.
Yes?
You know that thing when you're driving with your mom, and even though you got a seatbelt on, when she makes a sudden stop, she puts her hand over you?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, I do that to Mark, or to Eli, when the thing jumps out. Just let it be known.
Oh, even though he's safe on your shoulder, you're gonna cradle him like the bad one. Let me see. I have to find... Hang on. God damn it. Fucking A. Why does this always happen? Ethan! You have time for one snap action as before this strange, feathery scrawl creature hits you. Will you cast mage armor or do something else?
I'm going to cast a mage armor.
You should also keep...
You cast mage armor! You are being attacked with... Oh, god damn it. An attack roll! Oh!
You're being attacked with a god damn it. A curse used.
This is mockery.
Ethan! Oh! Your AC is 16, right?
Yeah.
Well, it got 16.
Uh-oh.
And defender don't win.
Oh. Get fucked.
Bye-bye.
Ethan.
Yeah?
You take... 6 damage.
Mm-hmm.
And I need you to roll a strength saving roll.
What does this thing look like?
That ain't happening, alright? Just letting you know that.
What?
My strength saving throw is going to be a -1.
Well, you need to roll. The DC is not that hard. Maybe you can get it.
Oh!
I rolled a 2 on the dice.
Ethan has been knocked prone into the pathway by what appears to be an extremely angry brown and bright purple chicken creature. After Ethan hits the ground, it says "Scraw" and tries to rake his body with its talons.
Cut it with my sword.
Okay.
All right. Mitzel sees this and says, "Okay, answer."
I will.
Roll the sword attack.
Basic melee. I got a 15. How'd that go?
With a 15. What is this thing's AC? Aha! With a 15, your sword connects with the back of its head. Splat! Roll your damage.
I did 6 damage to it.
Wow, that's pretty good. Splat! Its nose, Ethan, it was about to bite you in the face.
Oh.
When Volantis smacked it in the back of the head, its head was instead pushed forward into the dirt, and it got a mouthful of leaves and roots. Horrible, nasty amount of vegetarianism. It just spits it out and tries to run away.
That's very gross.
Wait.
Yeah, it's legit trying to run now.
Wait. Aw, man.
Well, I mean, it hasn't successfully run away, and Josh gets a turn.
It's not my turn.
Okay, so how tall is this thing?
It is precisely 3.5 feet tall.
Oh, so it's about my height.
A little taller than a turkey.
Oh, cool. All right, I'm going to go for a grapple. I'm just going to try to grab the fucking thing.
Uh-oh. Roll strength to grab, then. All
right.
It's like, oh, you little dick!
All right, let's...
Big-ass dragon hand reach out, grab a turkey.
Oh, actually, this thing's taller than me. I'm only 2'11".
Mother.
No wonder it went for you. You're like the most delicious tiny morsel in the group.
Okay, I got a 9 total.
With a 9 total, no, you went to grab for it, it jumped out of the way into the bushes.
Oh, alright, well, that was embarrassing.
After it does this, you hear, ha, 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 ha,
my, what silly sounding creatures.
Okay, quick. Can I, is my sense of hearing good enough to, like, determine if that's a call for help?
What's your passive perception, everybody?
My passive perception?
My passive perception.
In.
It's definitely. 9.
My passive perception is 13.
Alright. Ethan, what's yours?
10.
Currently, you're on the ground and everything sucks, but even your perception, Josh, being the lowest. Technically, the lowest person's passive perception is Eli. But even asleep, he could tell, snap, break, snap, crack, there's another one of those things hiding on the opposite side of the path.
Clever girl. So sorry. Clever girl!
What was that?
Does it sounds larger. Is it larger?
No, it doesn't.
Alright, well, fuck, I'm gonna go for it.
You're gonna go into the bushes after it?
Yeah.
Okay, sure, I'll allow it. Go for it. I'll allow it. Herman protests immediately. Maybe we shouldn't play into the... And then you start doing your thing.
While still carrying Eli, right?
Eli,
yes.
And I.
And Herman.
The best defense is a good offense.
So, what? You're just charging into the bushes and swinging at it. With what?
No, I'm going for another grab. Another grapple.
Oh, you're trying to grab it again. Okay, roll strength.
Haha! Much better roll this time. Okay, I got 12. What? I got 15 total.
15 total.
The dirty bear is trying to choke the chicken.
You grabbed the little creepy thing around its neck. As you pulled up, you realize its head is a lot more reptilian than avian. It has a set of hands attached on the ends of its wings that it claws at your forearm with, doing a negligible amount of damage. It scraws. And you guys see a lot of feathery tails pop out of the ground and start moving, not out of the ground, pop out of the bushes and start running in different directions. They appear to be attempting to reorganize. And there's about 5 of them.
Uh-oh.
Huh. Okay, I'm gonna walk back out of the bushes towards my friend. Gentlemen, I'm
waiting
out. Problem.
You're still holding the little turkey chicken.
Oh, yes, I am.
Scraw. Scree, scraw.
I want to attempt to animal handle it. I'm going to be like...
Hey, this is my chicken.
Okay.
This is my chicken.
You really went out of your way for that chicken there.
Hey, I'm thinking about dinner for us.
I, I want to attempt to calm
I
it down.
Any guy would just
all his friends want to try and eat
us.
Wants
to eat.
Volantis.
What's up?
Right. Bink! You felt something ricochet off your back armor. It didn't hurt you, but something definitely just tried to hit you. It's another one. Standing in the center of the road, looking at you. Scraw, it says, while opening up its hands.
Is it, is it close enough to just, like, stomp on it?
Cause.
Yes.
Yeah,
you
sure,
could try that. Roll melee with unarmed. Melee
unarmed sounds good.
It's like...
fucking... poof. I got a... 16 on my die.
With a 16, you actually step on its back! Pinning it to the ground. Scraw, it says.
Finish it with my sword.
And another one comes out of the bushes to attack you.
Oh.
Alright, Mitchell, roll your sword attack on either the one on the ground or the one
on
attacking
the ground.
You from the side. Alright, roll with advantage.
I got an advantage of 18.
Alright, you stabbed him good! Damage, please.
Ooh, ghetto crit for 10.
Okay, let me roll for this poor little thing.
Ghetto crit?
Yeah, I do a d8 plus 10.
Ghetto crit is when you roll maximum...
or not 10, but a...
Ghetto crit, two. Josh, is when you roll maximum damage without getting a crit. Though crits work differently now. Now you add dice when you crit. Like, you just get more dice to roll for damage.
That's crazy.
Nice. Yeah, remember when I did 32 damage to Safo?
Right, right.
Yeah, that's how you did, like, fuck all big old dick damage. Alright, you smack the one on the ground, stabbing him through his chest. He doesn't die immediately, but you can tell he's wounded. However, the one leaping out of the side definitely slashed one of your ears through your helmet.
Really?
Doing a 6 damage to you.
Holy shit, man. You got, half your blood. Like...
Josh, the one that you have in your hand appears to be scrawing things to the other little scrawborgs.
Huh, I'm gonna try intimidation on my chicken dinosaur.
Would you say that you are, you're choking the chicken there?
I'm just going to, roar in its face.
Okay, Josh, you specifically get to roll charisma for that.
Cool, alright, well I have a 9 charisma, but a -1 on it. Let me roll.
Well, wait, are you trying to intimidate, though?
I mean, I just kind of assume I have intimidate because I'm a giant, scary monster, but...
Well, Dragonborns, I thought, racially had an intimidate bonus.
Whoa, are you being race? Let me look.
It would say on your word,
intimidation +1.
Okay, so roll that one. Very nice.
Okay, cool. But then my charisma is a -1, so...
No. Just look at the skill. Included. The skill is all that matters.
Oh, all right, well, yeah, it's +1, so I got a 15 total.
With a 15 total. Okay, yeah, the little scraw stopped scrawing. It's just looking at you, terrified. Its tail is curled up between its legs.
Oh, I'm gonna pet it.
You pet it, and it is still terrified.
Right, cool.
Is pet, but is now still terrified. But it stopped giving orders. Ethan, it is now your turn.
Alright,
Hey, McTavish, you should try that animal handling thing now. We can play good cop, bad cop.
I was hoping somebody who was more wise than myself. I mean, was that in character?
I mean, anytime you want to speak as your character, my friend.
I was hoping somebody more wise than myself might attempt to do that.
Okay, look.
Right here, baby.
I'm a giant lizard.
Headmaster?
Eli is out.
Can you
attempt? And there's a fucking criminal right there. This is the best we got.
So, I'm a criminal one time.
My headmaster just... My headmaster just suggested that he do it.
I mean,
he just said he was more wise than you. That's what he said.
Headmaster, can you... attempt to handle these animals?
Do I look like I got hands?
I mean, it's called handling, but does it really require hands?
I don't want to turn a phrase in, smartass.
I think...
But I literally can't handle animals. They think I'm jerking.
But they do.
True. True. I vote we run away.
Scraw, scree, scraw, scraw, scree, says one of the scraws in the bushes.
I'm about to start a forest fire in this motherfucker.
Well. Well, what you gonna do?
Wait, hold on. Is there gonna be some kind of bullshit, like, butterfly effect if we start a forest fire and we go back to the present?
How do you think gasoline was made? And charcoal and all that. Burnt down forests and dead animals.
Oh, shit, if you want a forest fire, I can just breathe on, like, you know, these bushes.
I mean, I can do firebolt as a cantrip.
Gentlemen, I'm not really sure we should be starting forest fires, considering we're in the forest.
I want some roast chicken.
I'm gonna pull out my wand.
I mean, I feel like there's gonna be another 700 of these things. Why don't we just leave?
Welcome to Jackass.
Okay, how about we just kill them? Because the only one at real danger here is gonna be Tiny Benjamin.
Hey. Yes. Hey.
What?
Whoa. Hey, McTavish.
Yeah?
Yes?
You won't burn down half the jungle to kill 5 chickens. No balls.
I'm gonna
fucking do it.
Welcome to Jackass.
Hi, I'm out.
Ooh, 19 on the dice.
Put that head away. This is just not working.
Did you did the fireball?
Yep. Yeah. That's okay. A 23 overall to hit.
Did you aim that at any of the little squirrels?
Oh, yes, the one that is not under Mitchell's foot, and not the one that Josh carrying, the one that was jumping at Volantis.
Okay.
Right?
Everybody, except for Eli, not Eli. Eli would not be able to observe this, but he might give you a thumbs up in his unconscious state. Considering you point your wand at that scraw, he doesn't seem to know what's happening for a moment. He just sort of looks left and then right. And that's when a wall of fire explodes out of the end of it. And does roll your damage.
7 damage.
Wow. Impressive.
Yes.
Well, you lit that guy on fire!
Oh.
And he ran into the bushes, unable to put his own fire out by rolling in the dirt, considering that failed saving throw.
Excellent.
Okay, yeah, the other ones are pretty freaked out.
Most excellent.
They scree-scraw, and then you see the big one coming out of the bushes.
Nice, it's mine. Okay, so how big is the big one?
The big one is as tall as you, Josh.
Nice!
And has a lot less feathers because it's not a chick.
Okay, so I'm just going to throw the one in my hand to the side.
Okay. It makes a tiny, helpless peep as it smacks into the bushes.
Oh, he's found his thing.
This is my thing.
We can't keep it if you catch it alive.
Says you.
The creature takes a step forward, opening its jaws, and then every tree around you shudders. It pauses, looking off to the east. The trees shake again, says the big one. The little peeps start peeping. Scraw, scraw, scree, scraw, peep, peep.
This is a problem.
The big one starts backing away, moving off into the jungle.
Oh, goddammit.
And that's when an Allah-fucking-saurus comes out of the tree line.
Run?
Yeah, running is a great option.
Yeah, sure. I ain't got a reason to stick around at this.
And you run! Raw athletics! All of you.
Three.
Oh, boy.
Wow. Eight. Oh, no.
Okay, so I got an 18, and my athletics is +5, so I definitely make it.
Josh, you were sprinting like a Olympic champion. However, you could audibly hear the sounds of your friend in armor struggling to move, and Ethan tripping over his own feet.
God damn it.
Because he's wearing a giant lady robe.
What? Oh. All
right, well, actually, okay, can I pick him up by the robe?
You're going to have to roll athletics to be that fast, but yes, if you make it, you can grab McTavish, because the Allosaurus is looking at him like he's a tasty McNugget.
Okay, I rolled a 21 total.
Mick.
Yeah.
Mitchell? Roll athletics to move fucking faster.
On it.
Did
you just say McTavish looks like a McNugget? McTavish, yes. McNugget.
He's a McNugget-ish.
Get the fuck out of here.
Dang it.
That'll be an 11 to move at a reasonable speed.
You are now moving at human nice. Speed. Thanks to McTavish attracting the Allosaurus's attention by being bright fucking blue in a green jungle, you are not currently being actively pursued by the Allosaurus.
So,
however, what did you get on that athletics, Josh?
I got 21 total.
21 total?
Wait, do I need to roll?
McTavish. What do you... You could either roll dex to get out of the way of the Allosaurus, but Josh appears to be coming back for you with the football music playing.
What can I do to assist him? Hold my hands out?
At this point, probably. Or probably slow down the Allosaurus somehow so he doesn't just destroy you guys
the big
after
thing?
He grabs you.
Wait, you cut out for a second. Slow down what?
You could probably try to do something to slow down the Allosaurus, because it's definitely going to keep chasing you, after Josh takes you out of, like, harm's way.
Oh, you know what I realized? I did mage armor on myself earlier. I didn't roll wild magic.
Uh-oh.
Oh, that's a 3. Okay. Whew, that was
that's
close, though.
That's a 3. Though. He's all right. No, don't worry about it.
Oh. Fire orb. Fire.
The fire you already started in the jungle.
Chromatic orb.
Oh, hey! Fire!
What is it versus?
My chromatic orb?
What is... Yeah, what's it versus?
What do you mean versus? It's regular attack.
What, so you roll attack?
Yeah.
Roll that attack then!
Although... believe I have my... Hunt of Chaos? To get advantage on this one.
You really want to do that right now? I mean, that's fine. You could do that.
Yes, I do. Of course I do.
Gonna get fucking wrecked, scrub.
Of course I want my Tines of Chaos.
Last time that got you a new buddy, but also cost you your life.
And?
He's like, one time.
Well, at least now we know that his master definitely rubbed off on him.
No balls won't do it. Chromatic Orb.
Is that the one I want to use?
Oh my god.
Hey, you're a Digimon!
Bro, dude.
That is a 19 on the die.
I remember.
I wish I had, like, that crit on a 19 or 20. That'd be fantastic.
What was that, Mitchell?
Does anyone remember, like, Inuyasha and that really tiny demon thing that followed Moroku around? Dude, like, you sound just like that.
Oh, yes,
you sound
I do.
Just like
oh,
that.
Oh, god, he does!
Oh, I've never watched
fucking...
that.
Wait,
what was
on,
that thing's name?
Do the voice again?
Hello? Do you understand?
Yeah.
Oh,
what
God.
I'm saying?
Why do you have
it
to remind me of that bullshit?
It wasn't Naraku. It was Shishomaru.
Yeah.
Sheshi.
I should know.
I know of
was,
nothing of this.
That was my first husbando.
Right. Oh, yeah.
Of course
she
would know
husbando.
Way better, Inuyasha.
Well,
no. Than I, do.
I mean, I was definitely really into that.
I remember.
Whip out my wand.
He whips out his wand.
That's it.
Dude,
and
put
I'm
away. This is not the time.
Pelvic thrust one of these chromatic orbs at him. At a 23.
Wait, you did with a 23 on the attack?
Yeah, 23 to hit.
23 to hit? Mm-hmm. Let me see, that is against his AC. And that is a freaking. Let's see, what is his name? His name was Aun.
Aun.
Yeah, that was a shitty name. But you hit the Allosaurus in the mouth!
Noise.
Fucking.
Right. Oh, also, I choose. What kind do I want? Let's do acid damage. Because I want this.
Josh?
I want this Allosaurus to be tripping balls.
You ran back and grabbed Ethan. As you were pulling him, just barely out of harm's way, his wand exploded into a corrosive bile into the creature's mouth.
Gross.
It spews out the acid as far as it can. How much damage did you do?
12 damage.
That's pretty good damage. It doesn't look that hurt.
Oh.
Pissed off, and like you gave it some mouth sores, but not that hurt.
Run!
Run.
Mitchell, you've been moving at human speeds this entire time. As you are running back to the clearing, the Allosaurus is hot on you guys' tail. There's currently a dead run from the edge of the clearing back to the Temple of Mongo Bongo.
Wait, we're headed back the way we came?
Yes, currently it's the only way, because the Allosaurus came from the jungle.
The temple's all busted up and fucked.
We could Scooby-Doo. And split up. What's that thing that you guys got? The orb of some bullshit?
You definitely got the making stone of the earth.
Making stone.
Can we fuck with that?
Listen. If you can if you want, the consequences could be never the same.
Well, you know, I love messing with magic. Who's currently holding this stone?
I thought I picked it up, right?
Herman?
Currently, Mitchell has the stone.
Oh. If Dirge is going to be carrying me, I'm going to look over to Volantis and be like, give me the stone! Maybe I can figure something out!
I'm going to look at the stone in my hand and I guess pass it to him.
It is... It glows like a plot device as you hand it to Ethan.
Such a piece of shit.
Fuck you, what?
I'm going
to... You run it, bitch!
Insult my master, really quickly.
Wait, excuse me?
Do you recall anything about the making stone of Earth?
It's one of the most powerful and complicated magical items ever created. Along with all the other making stones. What else you want to know?
Well, I got it right here. What can I do with it?
Bullshit!
I want to, like, rub it on his face and be like, can you see that?
Huh. No? No, okay. Okay, you right. You got it. Let me see here. Well, with his 23 on history check, he would tell you that, well, I think you should just put your will into it and find a rock to make come alive.
Oh.
Or.
How powerful are you? I mean, really, we can't tell that with you. You've always been unstable. The results could be, well, they'll be just like you.
Are you calling me unstable? I don't appreciate that right now.
Exactly why he
you got an entirely different body than you did 10 minutes ago.
That's beside the point. Okay.
And a lisp.
I'm gonna look for a big old boulder.
Look around. Roll perception. As you do that, Mitchell, the Allosaurus has caught up with you because you're only running at human speed.
I'm gonna try and run faster, I guess.
Roll athletics versus the Allosaurus's athletics.
This time, I got a 14 on my athletics.
You ran with everything you were worth. You could tell that Melantis' legs are pumping and working, and his lungs are straining, and the Allosaurus, having a stride of about 11 feet, catches up in 2 or 3 steps.
Yep.
It brings down its bite attack.
Armor?
See, what's your armor again? 19, was it? Well, that's convenient, considering that's exactly what it got. The mouth comes down, and that is when... The Allosaurus is filled in the neck with crossbow bolts.
So we're early enough to have crossbows turn.
A guy comes out of the jungle swinging on a heavy cord rope.
Tarzan.
He flies through the air and rolls on that one. Yeah, the Allosaurus catches him in his jaws. And then it eats him.
That was impressive. Let's keep running.
That was impressive. Let's keep running.
All right, I'm for that. Okay.
I'm sorry, guys. That guy was intended to be your quest hook, but he rolled a nat 1 on the air attack, and the Allosaurus...
Just ate him.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was Jack Daxon, son of Dak Jackson, but he's fucking dead now. Well, you can tell that because his hat fell out of his mouth and landed on the ground.
Wait, how close is it to us?
It's right in front of you.
I want to grab the hat.
Damn it, you snatched that dead man's hat! Mitchell, that bought you enough time to keep running at human's feet.
Well, I rolled a 4 to look for boulders.
Alright, and you see a rock about the size of a coconut.
I'm gonna point dirge over to it.
I'm not fucking taxi,
You're carrying me!
Be like, get it! I need that!
Okay, I threw him at it.
Oh!
You've landed next to this rock, McTavish. Unceremoniously.
What is it with you and getting air mailed?
Next time, use your
I am going to.
Yous.
I have a making stone of earth. I have a rock. Put them together.
Fuck you with your memes. Roll Arcana.
All right. I should have saved that wild magic for this one. That's a 20 overall.
With a 20, the making stone and the rock you are touching both come alight. It fills the clearing with the blinding shine of creation. Your magic, you can tell, enters the stone and is refracted like a prism into 1,000 different wavelengths and then coalesced into the very essence of life itself.
Pretty fucking cool.
It enters the tiny rock creature, which grows one little rolling eye and four little limbs. It falls out of your hand, stumbles around on its stumpy little legs, falls on its face. Its eye pops back up. It looks at you, Ethan, and says, "Father,
son,
I live."
What can you do? We have a short time, so talk quickly.
Looks over shoulder at Allosaurus.
The tiny cannonball looks at the Allosaurus. See, your thing was that total. Let me roll for something. The creature looks at... Well, the little rock thing looks at you, Ethan,
yes.
And it tells you, "Father, you have given me the greatest gift of all, which is life. For that, I will sacrifice myself." And starts running at the Allosaurus.
Single teardrop.
Man.
So I watched him heroically sacrifice himself.
20-foot radius sphere centered on that point. Dex saving throw. See that much and that. There we go. Okay.
So let's see.
Ethan?
Yes?
What is the saving throw on your spells? What's the DC on your spells?
12.
12? That's still pretty possible to hit, then. The little guy runs up in front of the Allosaurus, raises up his hand, and says, "Know this, my name was Dwayne." As he starts to glow.
Wait, hold on. Wait, pause. One sec. So this is my son, Dwayne the Rock.
Yes. The Allosaurus rolls its dexterity saving throw, getting a 6. He takes one arcane explosion, 4d6 of force damage. See, 5, 11, 13, 14, and another 4d6 of thunder damage.
Oh.
4, 9, 11, 13. So 13, 13. That's 26 damage. And
I'm so proud of him.
And is pushed 10 feet away from where the spell happened. The Allosaurus is KO. Oh, ding, ding, ding.
Oh, nice.
There's little caveman Kuwatoa running around his head.
Okay, so he's literally knocked out.
Yes, he's unconscious.
He's nice. Unconscious, not dead, just unconscious.
Not dead, unconscious.
Yeah, we should keep moving.
Maybe the Kuotori.
Like, tongue hanging out of his mouth, giant burn marks on his chest, he's out.
Should we even see if fucking Mr. Action Jackson over there is alive?
Mr. Action Jackson Maxon.
Was he chewed into pieces, or was he like...
Well, the thing definitely got him in its mouth and started chewing, but you guys see a sword come out of the creature's stomach. And a guy bursts out of that open wound.
Shit, he's a zombie killer.
Hold on.
Fucking now, hi! What a mad cunt! He looks over at you guys and... You put this bugger out, aye?
Yes.
Yeah? What my son did.
Your son? What happened to him?
He's dead now.
Oh, I'm not into any of that PC, mate. He hops out of the Allosaurus. Fuck on aye. Ye mad cunt. He looks over at the thing and kicks it. Then look back at you guys. Sai, you don't look like you're from this town, Pete.
Huh, and you can tell that.
Does he look like he's from this time period?
Considering he's wearing khaki everything. No.
Neither do you.
Well, that looks like my hat there, Gav.
Yeah.
He holds out his hand. You mind?
Hand it to him.
He puts it on his head. It's still covered in blood, so is he.
Except the hat. The hat's not covered in blood, is it?
He says, well, bit of a pickle there, but I suppose I owe you my thanks.
Wait, how are you alive? We saw you get chewed.
Me, I'm alive. Because I'm square crazy cunt there, mate. Buddy, come on, Bones, in the buckaroo.
They're going
to take
you
to some big whopping fuck to go ahead and crunk me out.
What is he? You guys can understand him?
I lean over to Dirge. I'm like,
I don't have comprehend language. I don't understand.
Mitchell, you can tell that he is speaking a dialect of common that some elves speak. Ones from the Feywild that don't wear clothes.
Immediately stepping back.
Well, actually, you know, I would think it would be elves from the Underdark, the land down under.
Ethan?
Yes?
You can come up with your own magical puns in your adventure! But that is pretty fucking brilliant. But yeah, Mitchell, he's definitely not... he's speaking common, and you can tell it's an elven dialect, but this guy don't look like an elf. He's got the biggest square jaw any of you have ever seen on a human being.
Damn.
Perfect 5 o'clock shadow with an expertly waxed mustache despite being completely stained in blood. He asks, so, what are you cunts doing here?
Just kind of ended up like that.
Wait, where's Herman? He just...
Herman is on top of Josh.
Josh is just... So Josh was carrying Eli over his shoulder, me in one hand, and Herman's just like gripped onto his head.
No, I threw you, remember?
Oh, I mean before you threw me.
Oh, yeah.
Like, you were running away from the Allosaurus with all of us on you.
I didn't do shit last episode. I literally slept the entire time. So, I mean, I'm here to help you.
Herman is currently doing calculations on top of Josh. Let's see if this is year 75.
Herman,
yeah,
do you know where this guy came from? Excuse
me?
Do you know where this guy came from?
He looks over at dude. Excuse me? I would say he is somewhere from the 8th or 7th age. You guys know that the age you were in was the 5th age.
Hmm.
Wait, so he's from further along than us?
Yes, I would say so.
You're from the future!
So, we all from the future here, mate.
I mean, relative to us.
Oh, yeah, I suppose. Yeah, sure.
Also, one small thing. I just realized, because I googled blue halfling. Do I look like a smurf?
Probably.
A bit. A little.
Damn it.
Hey. It's more like a burnt blue. It's not like... neon blue. You've got black in there as well.
Okay, that's good.
Oh, you know, I thought my time machine was probably the only one in existence. Thought I had the first one.
I want to ask him if he actually knows who killed JFK.
We don't talk about that, mate.
Not sure I recall that, mate.
Well,
never heard of any JFK.
Damn it. Well, I thought I'd give it a shot.
He apparently doesn't get those kinds of references.
He's not that far off.
Shit.
He asks you, did anybody ever find Waldo?
Yeah, page 37.
Every time I go to the bathroom, my friend.
Excuse me there, Mr.
That would be Dexon name, right? Jackson Dexon.
One more time, what's your name?
Son of Dak Jackson. I would say that's their Jack Dexon, that's what you said. Son of Dak Jackson.
Okay.
What's his name? I still can't
Legendary Explorer.
If you were able to be overcome by a creature roughly that level, I would say that probably put you somewhere around level 5-ish, actually.
You always keep your mouth open that wide? You know, flies getting that shit.
So, Mr. Daxon, why are you here in this time?
Well, the only thing that's worth doing, mate, getting your knees dirty, putting your eyes, and he points behind him, and bagging some big fucking bodies, mate.
For what purpose might you be bagging these bollies?
Charging admission, of course! All about the big cha-ching!
Okay, allow me to translate, I suppose.
Please do!
If you wouldn't mind one more time, Mr. Daxon.
Aw, sense! I'm out here banging around with me bollies trying to get some cha-ching, mate!
Okay, I'm going to pretend I understood most of that and explain the bit that I did. He apparently is from the future, as we surmised. Yes. Travels here in a... What did you say?
Well, it's not really complicated there, mate. I'll say it's a time machine. Okay.
Right. Does it work?
First off, that's impossible.
Says Herman, raising up his finger.
Hey,
fuck you! You grey muppet. How'd you get here, then?
With magic, of course. Like sensible people. Something that's real.
That's right. Herman, the magical talking gray mouse creature, doesn't believe in time machines.
It's ridiculous. You can't have a machine that travels through time.
Oh, yeah, some kind of machine that travels through
Herman, time. Herman, maybe it's like a machine that reads a scroll for you?
Nah, mate, the machine ain't got no eyes. You pull the lever, you travel through time. It's your time machine, eh?
Does it work? If so, where is it?
Of course it works. And I've got it. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here.
Makes sense.
Could you take us back to our time?
He looks up at the sky like he's really inconvenienced. Can't even go back to the bloody bugger, eh, without some rippet coming along and trying to snizzle me wickets.
I mean, it's probably on the way back to your time. So, if we can help you here...
I'm pretty sure those weren't words.
Mr. Daxon, if we help you here, you can help us get back.
Daxon pulls his mustache out, and it flicks back, throwing blood in the opposite direction. Yeah, alright. Tell you what, mate. You do me the big easy of snagging one of these here big bodies, kicking like breathing witch, and I'll give you free tickets back in me time machine.
Alright, I'm done.
So
I assume
you want us to kill something big.
Some kind of like helping each other out, right?
Say what, Josh?
I assume that we just exchanged some kind of, like, helpful barter trade thing, right?
I believe he's asking us to capture a dinosaur for him.
Alright, yeah, hold him down.
Bomb that! Here's your instructions! He hands you guys a piece of paper. Good luck there, mates! Meet me back here in an hour!
Wait, what?
An hour? Hold on, what are we looking for? It's on the paper, mate! Valentis has been handed the piece of paper from Jack Daxon, who then walks back off into the jungle saying, "Later days, cunts! See you here in an hour!"
Read the paper.
Okay, so I say we should follow him secretly.
What, Josh?
Let's follow him secretly.
None of us here are trained in stealth.
I don't know for this.
Damn it, alright, fine.
I'm just gonna say that out.
Herman raises his head and says, "I am."
Herman is the only one
Hold
who
on.
Trained in stealth.
I'm sneaky. I'm not trained in stealth, but I'm also naturally stealthy.
All right.
I can.
You should follow him and see if he if he goes back to his time machine, and if that's the case,
I don't...
then we should just fuck his time machine.
Gentlemen, I hate to say this, but I don't want to do that.
Oh, all right. Well, that's fair.
If I did that, and I was captured by a dinosaur of some kind, or, God forbid, Jack Daxon himself, I would be, without my powers, or my master's powers at least, what's the word that you use?
Fucked.
Yes, that. I'd be that. Even though I wouldn't have any orifices.
Hermit, do you think potentially we could steal his time machine?
It's impossible to steal something that doesn't exist.
He says, folding his arms.
I am pretty certain that he's using some sort of magical artifact that allowed him to travel here in time.
Yes, but could we steal that?
I mean, probably.
In theory, but it could be incredibly complicated to operate, or...
What's more difficult? The three, four of us, trying to capture a giant creature, or stealing a time machine?
Let's see.
Stealing something that might not exist. In your opinion.
Let's see here. Herman says the guy's level 5, and there's three of us.
Alright, okay. How about
and
this,
I'm
though?
Level 3. I don't know about you guys, but I'm level 3.
Your armor is tingling, Mitchell.
Look down.
Because that sounds suspiciously like some evil plotting.
Alright, how about this? What dinosaur does he want so bad, Volantis?
What dinosaur does he want? Read it. What dinosaur does he want?
Oi, cunt! So you're here to help out Jack Dixon in his quest to bring up these bonnies and take them in for the kachin! Right on there! Good on you! Alright, so if you're looking for one of these here, there's three big ones, which I've been having a right cunt of a time trying to wrangle.
Mm-hmm.
And it says, for translation, see reverse side.
I mean, let's see reverse side.
The reverse side, it says, hello. I understand you. Looking to assist me.
It's like Microsoft Sam.
Hello. I understand you are trying to assist me in capturing dinosaur and other prehistoric life forms in order to make a profit within my current timeline. I appreciate this. Cunt.
Alright, keep reading.
The three that I myself have had great difficulty in capturing is the Plesiosaurus, which is located in a lake half a mile west of here. The Pterodon, which is located atop of a mountain 2 miles west of here. And, of course, the Triceratops, who is always lapped in a battle with the Tyrannosaurus Rex, a quarter of a mile south of
that
here.
That one. We're doing that one.
But I like the Plesiosaur.
No, we're doing this
one. I heard a story once about one who was in search of money.
Did he say that it was always locked in battle with the Tyrannosaurus Rex?
Yeah. Would you go with that one?
That doesn't sound like something an animal does.
Always locked in battle with the Tyrannosaurus Rex.
That sounds like something a spirit does. Or possibly a god.
Interesting.
Maybe a god could help us get back to our timeline.
If it could ever understand us. Look, prehistoric gods are probably even more difficult to understand than our own.
We'll talk slowly.
It works! I think that's a great plan!
We're gonna do it.
Fist bump smashed.
With Eli unconscious, there is no clear leader at the moment.
I mean, alright. I guess we can go off towards it. We'll take everyone down to the T-Rex that won't stop fighting.
And we're off! Little floating heads of you guys along a giant map of this prehistoric jungle travel through.
I'm going to see a T-Rex. I'm going to see a T-Rex.
And you arrive at what appears to be the site of an active volcano.
Oh, wow.
On these lava plains, there doesn't appear to be anything you can see, but this is the spot marked on Jack Daxon's map.
How long did it take us to get here?
Oh, about an hour and a half of walking through dense jungle. You saw a mosquito at one point the size of a house cat.
Wait, it took us an hour and a half to walk here?
Yes.
So Jack Daxon's...
Oh, wait, pardon me. He said to see you back there. It took you a half an hour to... It took you about a half an hour to walk here. At one point, you saw a mosquito the size of a house cat that got eaten by a bullfrog the size of a man.
Did it look appetizing?
I mean, the frog was certainly satisfied with itself.
Well, mosquitoes suck, so I'm fine with it.
I wish I didn't have ears so I didn't have to listen to you sometimes.
That thing could probably suck out all my blood in one go.
Oh yeah, probably. Imagine what it could do to you.
Then I'd look like you.
Oh.
Yeah, but not as handsome.
Oh. You're not wrong.
Oh. That was humble. Valantis, Herman is tapping your shoulder. Ting, ting, ting.
What's up, little guy?
Even if we locate these creatures, how exactly do we intend to trap either of them?
I haven't thought that far. I'm just trying to find it first.
Please. Let's stand on the volcano and look down. We'll have a high vantage point.
And possibly be incinerated by lava, could we not?
Well, that's my idea.
I mean, how do you just walk up a volcano surface anyway? Like,
with your feet.
Lava planes here.
Very carefully.
You guys can definitely hear the sounds of something happening around, like, just on the other side of the volcano.
Could I, like, fashion some coconut shoes or something just so I don't, like, burn my feet?
We can hear some shit on the other side of the active volcano.
Yes. It sounds kind of like...
All right. If we can hear this shit from all the way over here, not even taking into account the volcano, that's loud as shit, we should go there.
The ground itself does not appear to be full of lava, but the volcano is clearly active as it is drooling magma down the side of it. Like a big old dick in a hentai.
Ooh.
I mean, I guess.
That is one of my Japanese animes.
Is this a phallic volcano?
Somewhat.
Oh.
Vaguely. Like, if you were really, if you were leaning, towards the air of side of seeing dicks, then you'd definitely see a dick in this volcano.
If you're the type of person who naturally sees dicks just out in the wild, you'd think
then you're gonna see a dick right here.
You're like, that tree? That tree kind of looks like a dick. Them coconuts?
That looks like a dick. That's some big circular dicks. As you guys trounce out into the volcanic fields, eventually you start rounding the volcano and you see a T-Rex wrestler-style sprawling a Triceratops.
Yeah, it's my favorite dinosaur.
The T-Rex, let me roll his strength.
That is probably one of the coolest things I've ever envisioned.
It flips the Triceratops over. The Triceratops doesn't recover terribly well. The T-Rex goes for his exposed stomach. But the Triceratops swaps him in the head with his giant armored tail. The T-Rex stumbles. The Triceratops manages to roll to his feet, charges the T-Rex. The T-Rex has to sprawl him again. They crash through a gigantic boulder, turning it into gravel.
Do I have popcorn?
Oh, bye.
Says Herman.
Is there any popcorn left from the stadium?
There's definitely some coconuts that have popped into giant popcorn.
Oh, I can't eat that.
You can't eat that?
I mean, I can, I just don't like it.
Herman asked, I'm sorry, are you still hungry?
Always.
I'm sorry to hear that. Let me see if I can... He can't conjure any food.
Damn it!
I'm sorry.
It's okay, you try. That's the important part.
Wait. He made one corn chip.
Well, I can't have one, because who in their right mind eats one corn chip?
So he breaks
me!
It.
I'll take it out of his hand.
Very well.
Dump down mouth.
I suppose we have now learned that our friend has gone completely insane.
I mean...
Gentlemen!
Only a little bit.
Being resurrected takes its toll on you.
Gentlemen, you are now left with the pondry. How in the hell do we catch one of these things?
Alright, so...
Perhaps a giant rock creature.
We need to take the time machine to the Pokemon dimension. Making...
And that's when Josh's character suddenly grows a tumor the size of a toddler out of his neck.
God damn it!
Because if he's going to give me cancer, I'm going to give it back to him.
I ain't got shit after that.
Don't worry, you're in triage, it's gone. Magical hand wave, it's his hand.
Alright, well, shit.
Well, we could look for a giant boulder and try and make it active to help us subdue these giant dinosaurs.
Perhaps.
Yeah, that worked out so Lifts well last time. Movie.
Okay, okay, how about this?
It did! It subdued him! My son! He died for us!
Yeah, that happened.
Alright, well,
and don't you forget it!
I mean, I probably will forget it tonight.
Your armor kind of tingles again, Mitchell.
It hurts.
Like a warning tingle.
Alright, well, let's watch this and see how it ends.
Well, I'm gonna look at these dinosaurs that are fighting, and, do they look like regular dinosaurs, or do they look especially big or fancy?
The T-Rex looks, obviously, about double the size of the Allosaurus that you saw earlier. Mm-hmm. Its head is gigantic, lined with razor-sharp teeth. Its skin is a dark gray, and it is covered in bright red and pink stripes that go along its head and tail. The Triceratops is mostly green, with slate-gray armored patches that cover its skin. Thorny carbuncles grow out of its head in many places, and its actual plate is a giant antlered spread of horns that cover most of its back and, well, the rear part of its neck. They each appear to be, let's see, oh yes, each of them are huge class in size, meaning they take up a much larger area than a large class creature. Let me see. Oh, the Triceratops just got dead-stopped by the T-Rex. The T-Rex goes for its neck, only to have the armor plating of the Triceratops stop it, and the Triceratops flips the T-Rex into the air with his horn. He lands on the ground, breaking it open, causing a geyser of lava, which splatters over them both, and neither of them seem to burn.
God.
So, maybe they're both gods.
The T-Rex goes for the kill. Triceratops' skin is too thick. His jaws are wrapped around the Triceratops' neck. He catches a tail in the dick for his trouble.
Oh, I'm going to turn to Herman. And say,
you said they might be gods, or one of them, or something?
It is very likely at this point. The primordial forces are always in contention with one another.
And how would we tell? Arcana, perhaps? Magic?
Mayhaps, or see if they're ready. Well, no. The local savages would obviously worship something like this. He motions his hand toward them, so worship definitely won't tell us anything.
Wait, I'm gonna look around, like, towards the edge of the jungle or something. Is there any, like, Kuatoa or other creatures watching?
There is definitely a large altar made out of palm trees, sticks, and stones that faces this large clearing.
Let's walk over there and check that out real quick.
Alright. Okay. Your party goes over and finds indeed there is a tiny stepladder. Not stepladder, but a tiny staircase made out of ancient amber stones where preserved dinosaurs, bugs, and bones lay.
They create
an area that climbs up to a tall altar. In the center, there is apparently a little divot that is burnt out in the center. It is roughly, Mitchell, the size of the making stone.
Hey, put the thing in there.
I take it out of my shirt dress pocket and
shit,
set it on the altar.
Gentlemen, this might be sort of...
The making stone has hit the socket in this altar. I don't know why I let you guys do things in general. I mean, its light explodes off into every direction. You guys actually have your souls pushed out of your body before they snap back into place like rubber bands.
Alright, so...
I can write that off the bucket list. Soul out of the body.
The volcano is moving.
Oh.
We might have just fucked up colossally.
I mean, I don't want to move from this spot, though.
I do not move.
A silence that fills this area. A sort of reverence. The rumbling of the volcano is now very even. Almost purposeful. Like a hum. Or a murmur.
You know?
Maybe. Maybe it wasn't the dinosaurs that was the god?
Okay. This is way out of my handbook, boys.
Says Herman.
Hmm.
Yeah, mine too. I don't have it anymore.
Well, I mean, if I pull out my handbook, flip to page 47, it, nope, has nothing on this.
Well, shit.
A religion check might tell you something.
We can make it, sure.
Well, I am actually trained in religion, but it's not very high.
Damn it, I'm an atheist!
Put my hands together. I'm gonna be like, dear chaos gods, what might thou tellest me?
It's very dangerous to pray to the chaos gods, Ethan.
I mean... Who else am I going to pray to?
Alright, well, Mitchell, roll your religion check for me real fast. Oh,
that will be an 18 on religion.
So close.
Mitchell, with an 18 on religion, you know that the most ancient forms of worship were never directed at constructed gods or creatures from, well, the astral plane like it is in the modern age.
Uh-huh.
Before we puny mortals became aware of the amazing power that existed out beyond us, we worshiped the things that were there with us. The spirits of our ancestors, great beasts, probably like the two behemoths,
right,
and the earth itself.
Hmm.
This spot is clearly intended not as a sacrificial area or as a way to give worship, but instead a communication panel. A way to commune with the planet, or at the very least, with the earth that lay beneath the feet of the people that live here. By placing the Making Stone there, you may have activated an ancient rite, and the Earth itself is listening.
Hmm.
With this volcano being the point of origin.
Question. I might have just made one hell of a phone call.
Finish.
Huh.
So, question.
What's a phone?
Oh,
can
don't
you send
worry,
us
yeah.
home?
The Earth rumbles. And for some reason, you feel very at peace, as if you have always been home.
Alright. I mean, I guess that's fine.
Can you get us? Could it get us to the right timeline somehow? What messages can we send to the Earth? How do we talk to rocks?
Well, the Earth probably doesn't have a concept of time as we do. It has always been. It's matter. And matter often does not disintegrate at the same rate that we mortals do. Or you mortals, I forget.
It's alright.
Herman rolls his claws. We are probably communicating with what would essentially be considered a titanic elemental, and we've merely animated probably a tectonic plate, I would assume.
Well, we don't want to make it mad.
No, we don't.
Hmm.
But perhaps it could help us with our task at hand in other ways.
Hmm. Can it give us a dinosaur to give to Jack Dixon?
Off in the distance, you can definitely see that the Tyrannosaurus has lifted the Triceratops up and tried to body slam it into the ground.
He wanted the Triceratops, right?
Yes, he did. For some reason, he wasn't interested in the Tyrannosaurus. Probably because he couldn't catch it.
Could the Earth pacify the fucking dinosaurs in some way? We ask it to do that.
The Earth responds with... The ground underneath you guys cracks open.
Look down.
You definitely can see deep in there that there is a lot of fucking lava.
Hmm.
You can also see that there is a fuckload of lava elementals wading through that lava.
What do you do, boys?
They sort of look up at you guys, but you can tell that if they touched anything outside of that hole, it would just burn to death.
Hmm.
I give them a small wave.
They wave back.
Oh. Well, that's nice.
I really should have kept on to that chicken. I'm really hungry.
The earth rumbles and a tree leans down towards you, Josh. There appears to be a really huge spider in that tree.
Huh.
No, I'm not even fucking with that.
The earth pushes it at you in a sort of doting mother kind of way, like, don't be fussy, eat.
Okay, I grab Eli by the legs and try to hit the spider with his body.
Alright, roll real fast.
Alright.
Alright, that's actually, you know, don't roll for that. It's a giant dumbass spider. It's not like a god spider. You just smack the damn thing.
Alright, with Eli's body.
Spit! Eli's body is now covered in spider goo.
Alright, I put him back over my shoulder.
You now have one squished spider. It smells pretty good, actually.
Oh, no, alright. I guess I'm gonna start making a fire to cook it.
The earth is confused by what you are doing, but looks back at the rest of you. Well, look, and by look, I mean, like, you can feel its attention is now drawn away from Josh. It's back at you, Mitchell.
Okay.
Wow, Mitchell, the metal in your armor appears to be reacting to the presence of this giant elemental.
It appears to be reacting to the giant elemental?
Yeah.
How?
Since the tectonic plate underneath you is currently alive, the metal in your armor appears to be reacting somewhat.
Trying to understand. Look at the fucking armor. What's up here? Look down.
The armor is vibrating ever so gently. You can actually hold up your hand and there's some metal shavings down at your feet that are starting to move towards your foot.
I'm magnetic now? Really?
Yep. Ever so slightly.
Interesting.
I'm going to look around the altar for some metal.
There appears to be a very small amount of trace metal inside the altar, near the top. Since the creatures here probably don't know how to forge the metal, they appear to have taken anything that naturally formed. At the top, where the basin where the making stone is sitting, is definitely surrounded by very coarse iron.
I'm going to scoop some up in my hand.
You can. It's one big piece.
Oh.
Like it's a big bowl. Alright, you pull it off of the altar. When you do this, the making stone falls out of the hole. Tink, 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 and you guys feel the earth go silent again.
God damn, you broke it.
It leaves everything feeling empty.
I'm
gonna put it back then. My bad.
The bowl's back. The stone has rolled down the stairs.
Oh god, go get it. Like, I'll go get it.
You're right.
I'll
get it. Roll deck throw fast for me, Ethan.
Dexterity.
You gonna make him roll to catch a fucking stone?
Just raw dexterity?
Yes.
Yeah. 16 overall.
All right, that's not bad there, Ethan. You grab it just in time. You see tiny claws barely miss you as a strange-looking dinosaur with wings flies past you. Scraw, it says.
Strange looking?
Yes.
Familiar looking?
It has a long face, a long back of its head, and a pair of giant fleshy wings.
Wait, is that the thing? The one he wanted?
On the piece of paper, it does say that he was interested in a pterodon.
How small is this one? Is it big?
Oh, it's definitely small, not medium.
Okay.
Guys?
What's up?
Is this what he's looking for?
Something tells me he wants a big dinosaur, and I want a small one.
Scraw, it says from the trees.
It can fly, though.
Scraw.
Does the note make mention of size?
Oh, and by the way, if any of you are paying attention, the dinosaur fight has just, it's gone to RKOs now. The Triceratops has RKO'd the Tyrannosaurus.
And the Tyrannosaurus will RKO the trees. This is great.
Well, the Tyrannosaurus' homie just came out of the jungle with a chair and is now beating the Triceratops.
Just imagine that these tribal people built giant chairs just for the dinosaurs to fight with.
Oh, definitely.
Got big-ass stone chairs.
It's lasts somewhat of a long time, but the Tyrannosaurus betrays his buddy in order to get his chair from him.
Okay, I go looking around the forest to find the booth where Larry the King Lawler and JR are sitting.
You mean Lararuka the Grand Chief? It was me, Austin! It was me all along, Austin!
Oh, doggies!
You know, gentlemen?
Yeah?
If, I have an idea.
Oh.
It's risky.
And?
It's very risky.
But I'm in.
If we take that pterodon, he points at the one in the tree.
Yeah.
Back to Jack Daxon, it would at least possibly get him to take us back to his base camp, where we could then attempt to get into the time machine.
Wait, no, right? But you said the time machine doesn't exist.
It is at least theoretically there. I am only speaking in terms that you guys can get. I'm sorry. I fell into it, alright? I've given up on the mythology.
So you were listening to me with the stealing the time machine idea.
No, I'm not. I'm saying that we just use it, not take it.
Right.
My use master it. Would never condone me doing such a thing.
Yeah, but what if master? We use the time
Your master's
machine,
not born yet. You can break the rules.
But if you... No, he points at you. I follow those rules because I am a good person, not because I am forced to.
All right.
As long as you know you're saying I'm not.
Down on Josh's shoulder. He looks like a really wrinkly chihuahua when he does that.
I pet him.
He accepts the pet.
Nice. All right, well, let's grab this pterosaur.
But how, though? Scraw, scraw, come at me, bro, says the pteraton.
What is your wisdom, Josh?
Let me see. My wisdom is currently 8, and I get a -1 on rolls.
Oh, okay. Awesome. Volantis, you are wise, right?
Once I get this fire going, I'm just going to slap the spider on there.
Crunchy spider makes it pretty all right.
It sizzles deliciously, smelling exactly like you would expect the recipe for Mold of Warcraft to smell.
Okay, cool.
And with that, our heroes have begun their collusion to snooker Jack Daxon under the use of his time machine. Eli will probably be extremely confused and interested in dinosaurs when he comes back. But we're going to find out whether or not that's true. We're going to find out whether or not the Tyrannosaurus or the Triceratops will hold the ultimate Omega heavyweight belt for all time. Next time on Milk and